being a people pleaser is stopping me from doing the things that I want to do, and it's stopping me from getting to where I want to get. How to go from people pleaser to queen bitch. So one of my favorite quotes by Isaac Newton is, an object in motion stays in motion and an object at rest stays at rest, right? So I'm the type of person where I used to be a people pleaser. My thing was, I just wanted everyone to like me. I just wanted to be accepted. I wanted people to understand me, get where I'm coming from. And it was a lot of me more so wanting validation from certain kinds of people and feeling like how people feel about me, how people see me, and how people respond to me equals how I should see, feel, and understand myself. I had to say, you know what, like, at the end of the day, when I lie in that bed by myself, I have to put up with me. I have to sleep with myself at night knowing that I said yes to things that I knew that I wanted to say no to. Your thoughts, emotions, and actions. You guys, when I've learned this principle, it really set me from here. It set me from here to here. What you think shapes how you feel. How you feel shapes what you do. So you want to be the person where in your mind, heart, spirit, and the way that you move, everything about you says queen. And that doesn't mean that you move in a way where you want to be validated, accepted, and recognized by other people. Because at the end of the day, everyone thinks completely different, right? Everyone has different opinions and thoughts and beliefs and values when it comes to how they should carry themselves and what they understand you to be as. And sometimes, the worst thing you can do is to seek validation or to want to do things for attention. Because some people will intentionally not give it to you just because of the simple fact that they know that you want it. In order for you to have that energy, right? In order for you to have that queen girl energy, you have to be able to do little things that helps you to shape the way that you think, little things that make you shape the way that you feel, that can overall shape the way that you move. And when you're moving a certain way, when you're moving and when you're dancing, it's called motion, right? So the kind of motion that you want to have in your life, you have to be able to think in that motion. So in order for you to move a certain kind of way, in order for you to act a certain kind of way, you have to initiate that action in your mind and in your heart in order for you to act that way. So a lot of people don't understand a way that can really help you get into that T, and that formula is called TEA. That's the T, like thoughts, emotions, and actions. All of these equivalent to the thing that you focus on the most, and what you focus on the most is the energy that you will get into your life in your inner system, and you will see it in your outer reality. So if you see yourself as a high performer, you will show up as a high performer. A lot of times people forget that your self-image is how you're marketing to yourself who you are. Your self-image is how you are promoting to yourself who you are. A lot of times we are promoting to ourselves an image that we do not want to show up as. A lot of times we are promoting to ourselves an image that we do not want to be. A lot of times we are promoting to ourselves an energy that we do not want to have, and we're wondering why we're not getting the results that we want. It's because you see yourself as the very thing that you don't want to be. I'm gonna do my eyeliner and my lashes off camera, and then I'm gonna come back. So, moral of the story, if you think of yourself and feel of yourself and see yourself as a people pleaser, what will you show up as? A people pleaser. In order for you to really be that girl, that queen that you really want to be, you have to know within yourself. I mean, you have to think of yourself, feel of yourself, see yourself, and literally know, like, no, you can't, oh, like, I think, like, maybe I'm, no, you have to know. You cannot let the world tell you who you are. do not conform to the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. You are a individual. You are a person that was put on this earth to do something, be something, and to have certain things in order for you to be fruitful and multiply on this earth. So when I started to really understand who I am, what I'm supposed to do, and my purpose in my lane, like, it was over. I don't have to be fake. I don't have to show up in a way in which I'm not. Like, I don't have to lose my dignity and my integrity because of the simple fact that you think of me a certain way. I don't have to go tick for tack. I'm not on that one-up stuff, no nothing. If I feel like you weird and you phony and you just something, like, that's just that. There's no reason for me to try to fight to get you to see me as I really am. Or to see me as a human being that also makes mistakes. I'm at that point in my journey where it's like, if you like me, you like me. If you don't, you don't. It is what it is. And I feel like that's what a lot of us, especially growing up, we need to be able to embody, that whether you like me or not is not my business. How you feel about me, sis, bro, it's not my business. Like, that's on you that you feel that way and that you chose to not like me based off what somebody else said instead of coming to me and asking me what in the world happened. I've gotten to the point where I realized, like, if I'm really going to be who I was created to be in the likeness and image of who I was created to be, I can't be liked by everyone. And if I am trying to be liked by everyone, and if I want to be accepted and validated by other people, X, Y, Z, I'm doing something wrong. And if everybody likes me, then I'm doing something wrong. But if there is people that do not like me in the world, then I'm doing something right. Being a people pleaser is hard because when you look at certain people, especially when you look up to certain people, or where you want to be close with certain people, or where you want to be in a relationship with somebody, or whether you want to do a particular thing or be somebody, you think that the way to achieve that thing is by being, if I have to change who I am to achieve this thing. And to be honest, that's not authenticity. Your vibe literally attracts your tribe. You have to be who you are to the core authentically in order for you to attract something that aligns with you. The moral of the story, everything that a people pleaser does is to gain the acceptance and validation of everyone else but themselves. A queen, what she does is she works on gaining that resilience, acceptance, and loyalty to how she feels about herself. How she feels about herself when she lays down at night in the dark and there is no one else around to validate who she is. But deep down inside, she knows that she is that girl. And no one needs to tell her that she's that girl. She just knows that she's that girl. Because you detached and has separated yourself from the old version of yourself. So that's all for the video, you guys. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll be back for the next one. Bye.